For health and joy. I'm very happy you've joined us here today. Have you tried to do some yoga poses in some classes and not known the best way to do it or where your foot should be or how far apart? Well, good news. I'm going to share with you today some yoga alignment basics so you can grow your poses, prevent injury, and keep on expanding and enjoying your yoga even more. So let's begin in downward facing dog, a very popular pose. I want to teach you how to do it just right. So please come on down. Actually, come to your knees. This is a very short class. My name's Patricia Becker, your yoga instructor. So spread your fingers nice and wide, root down through your metatarsals and pads your fingers like you have gecko hands here. And the underside of your wrist, imagine it's lifting up. And then tuck your toes, squeeze your abdominal muscles, and then lift your hips up and stretch up through your spine. And you want to have your ears in between your upper arms. And then from the back of your heart, you press down through your arms, down through your metatarsals and the pads of your fingers. And then from the back of your heart, that same spot, you lift up your spine. So you're energetically taking your energy in two opposite directions, lifting your hips up. And then often we walk the dog just to loosen up the hips. So in down dog, you want to have your feet parallel, hip width distance apart, not like this and not like this, just hip width distance. Yeah, and you stretch it out. And then your arms frame your head. So this is a really good downward facing dog. So practice this until you look just about like this. Okay, so that's downward facing dog. And then bring your hands to your hips, draw your shoulders on your back, root down through your legs and come on up. Okay, now we're gonna do triangle pose, Trikonasana. So please take a wide stance, squeeze your legs together, and turn your left foot out, turn your right toes in, and then get a block and put it on the outside of your shin. Stretch your arms way out, and then exhale your left arm down on the outside of your shin and place your fingertips down on the block. You want to have like a peace sign facing the same direction as your left toes. And then draw your top shoulder up, lift your top shoulder up to the sky, press your arm down, your fingers down into the block. This is the basics. And then you squeeze your kneecap and root down through both legs evenly. And then see if you can turn the underside of your belly up and stretch the top arm up to the sky. And then you want to make sure your head isn't hanging, get your head in line with your spine. Rooting through your legs and lengthening through your spine. And then when you come out of the pose, you root down to come up. And then turn your left foot in, turn your right toes out. And then you turn the back toes in, root down through your legs, stretch them down into the earth, lengthen through your spine, stretch out through your arms, even through your fingernails. So you don't want to stretch like this, right? That's non-yoga. Yoga is connecting to your whole body and your breath. You can even turn up the corners of your mouth. And then exhale your right hand down on the outside of your right shin onto the block. You can choose the level you prefer. Peace sign facing the same way as your right toes. Root that arm down. Press your hips forward to open up the underside of your belly. and open up your sternum. Top shoulder reaches up towards the sky. And you root through your legs and keep lifting up and out. And breathe. And then you root down to inhale, back up. And then turn your feet parallel. And you can lower your arms, and we're going to turn it out again. And after you've been doing this pose for a while, and you start feeling comfortable, and your hamstrings start to get more open and more length in them, and your body gets more open and more length in it, you can do triangle without the block. We're going to set that block aside. So squeeze your legs together, lengthen through your spine, open your shoulders, and then exhale your fingertips down on the outside of your shin without the block. Same thing, peace sign faces that way. Your arm falls right underneath your shoulder, and you lift the top arm up. And you push your hips forward to open up the underside of your belly, underside of your chest, lift it up. And actually, you can actually push your arm into your shin a little bit to get more leverage. Trikonasana, triangle pose. And then you root down through your legs to come on up. And then turn your left toes in a little bit and right toes straight up. And then actually your front heel should be intersecting your back arch. Stretch up and out. Squeeze your belly muscles. Exhale your arms down. Press your arm into your shin back into your arm. And then root down into your legs. Inhale up. Turn your feet parallel. And then heel toe your feet together. And then we'll take them out again. And we will do a pose called Parsvakonasana. Please turn your left toes out, bend your left knee over your ankle, and you can place that block there again. And you want to get your knees stacked right over your ankle. This is a very common pose we do. It's called side angle Parsvakonasana. You can rest your forearm on your thigh. Root down equally through both legs. Usually you have to push down more through your back leg. And then stretch your top arm up and over. So you stretch the whole right side of your body. Press your hips in and open it up. It's good to know the biomechanics of these poses so you can continue to grow them safely and then really enjoy yoga for a long time. Root down, come on up. And then reverse your feet, knee over your ankle, forearm to your thigh. Pretend like you're reaching up and over a beach ball here. Root down more through your back leg than your front leg because the weight normally sinks into your front leg. And then stretch your arm up and over. Stretch the whole left side of your body. Turn and open your left shoulder, your left sternum up to the sky. Now, here, if you're comfortable, you can take your hand down on the outside of the block to take the pose a little deeper. And then maybe you can take the block away and put your hand down on the outside of your shin. And then root down to come on up. We like to make these poses accessible for everyone, so there's always different levels. As long as we're doing yoga, there's always more opening, more depth, more opportunity to grow and become aware of your body. So let's do another wide angle pose, Vira 2. Open up, knee over your ankle, just like Parsvakonasana. And then this is Virabhadrasana 2, Peace Warrior 2. Draw your shoulders back and you gaze out over your front hand. And then you push down your legs, reverse your feet. Knee over your ankle. And you want to make sure your knees directly over your ankle and maybe head it out a little bit over the little toe side of your foot. So you want to, you don't want to do this. You want to have your knees stacked right over your ankle. And then gaze out softly over your front hand. Virabhadrasana 2, Peace Warrior 2. And then root through your legs, come on up. feet parallel, arms down, and then you can heel toe your feet together. So that's just a little few basics of alignment in some of the yoga poses. We've got lots more classes at the YouTube channel, lots more classes on your public access station. So please come back and enjoy yoga. Thank you. And thank you, Prana, for your support.